Hello, everyone. This is your good old neighbor, Nick Kick, and Frozen 2, and Nope, Time to Die fan 2001, and welcome to the Netto Batman Review Week, leading up to that new Batman movie starring Robert Pattinson. It's way better than he was in Twilight, which honestly, no one gives a shit about that movie. Not five. No one gives a shit about that movie. And so, hey guys, and welcome back to another Batman Review Week, leading up to a new Batman movie coming out this year on March 4th. Man, I'm excited for that movie. It's going to be the longest Batman movie I'll ever watch in my lifetime. And so, hey guys, last time we'll talk about Michael Keaton Batman on Batman. And so, yeah, so today I'm doing a movie review on the sequel to the Batman Michael Keaton movie called Batman Returns, starring Michael Keaton. Danny Rovio, and I go voiced by Catwoman. I forgot what his name is, and I just saw the poster. You can comment section below. All right, Commedio of 1992. So yeah, let's get to part Chevy. Basis part of this movie. This movie take place in after first movie wrapped up, and so Batman doing normal stuff like always, doing Bruce Wayne like always, right? Hanging out with Alfred, beating up the crime, and being saving the world like always. And so Commissioner Gordon say we got Catwoman and Mitt the Penguin on the roofs, and so Mitt the Penguin grab a whole bunch of Penguin and Catwoman trying to be so attractive in front of the Batman, which honestly Michael Keaton as Batman didn't feel it. And so Michael Keaton gotta stop Catwoman and Mitt the Penguin before it's too late. And that's really basic part of this movie. It's just like the first movie but with different villain. And so, hey guys, after I watched this movie on my DVD, because I just have a double feature, because my thought on the double feature DVD, which honestly, the word to nitpick about the movie, about the DVD I got, it has to be the Switch DVD discs, which honestly, that is so freaking lazy. What, Warner Brothers, why would you do that? Jeff John, Walter Romana, and Tommy and Blake, why would you do that? Why would you make those Switch DVD on my DVD on Batman and Batman Return? I don't wanna go switch back and forth every time I wanna watch the movie. You screwed up my DVD, you idiot. That's the main reason I can stand Warner Brothers. You know what? Let's not talk about them anymore. And so yeah, after we watched this movie, and this movie was such a great movie, but this movie's good, but eh. Batman from 1989 is a much better Batman movie than this. And my favorite Batman movie has to be The Dark Knight Rises. And I'll probably you guys, hey Nick, during two, you're going to review all the Batman we have. Hey, why not get you do a redo review on the Christopher Nolan Batman, which honestly, I just don't feel like it. You know what? I will put that review on my playlist. Yeah, I would think about that, so. Sorry guys, I'm not gonna redo my review on Batman Begins, The Dark Knight, and The Dark Knight Rises. It's good what it is. It does age well, so hope you guys understand that. So yeah. And so hey guys, and I still have a little nitpick about the movie. I honestly do not like Danny Rovio as a Penguin, which honestly has got to be one of the weakest performances I have seen from him. But at least he's way better than he was in Madea, which honestly one of the most overrated movie of the 90s. I don't want to talk about the movie. That movie is so over the top and it's so disgusting. And I'll do a redo review on that movie in the future. Stay tuned for that. Oh boy. And so yeah, I really did not like the Penguin of this movie. So we'll see the Penguin from the Batman starring Robert Pattinson would be a much better Penguin than it in the VO. Don't get me wrong, I like Danny in the VO. He was in Hookery and he was in the Warwick, which honestly, well, even I despise the Warwick, but at least the Warwick voiced by Danny Rovio is sound like original Warwick. So yeah, and stay tuned for my the Warwick so ran on the anniversary. So yeah, stay tuned for that. And so yeah, in some scenes, just really drag, like it honestly like cut the bit. So yeah, this wasn't a nitpick of. Oh wait a minute. I think some scene of the movie is really completely unnecessary. So they can cut that for a bit. And the positive, like the story is really great once again, and Michael Keaton as Batman, once again, he's a great Batman, but I don't want Michael Keaton will be a new Batman from the DCEU canon. No, I don't want that. And my favorite kid of this movie, it has to be Catwoman. Catwoman is honestly one of the sexiest DC villain I have ever seen in my entire life, because Catwoman is a pretty attractive Catwoman. Man, I don't want to talk about that Catwoman for starting Halle Berry. Ugh, I don't want to talk about that movie. That movie is stupid. The movie's awful. And I'll do a rant of that movie after my Batman movie, leading up to that new Batman movie. So yeah, stay tuned for my Catwoman rant starting Halle Berry. Which honestly one of my new, honestly one of the second worst movie from 2004. Number one is Bad Apple. Get the movie out of my face. And so yeah, in the action of the film is a pretty action packed, and not enough to say about this movie. In the ending, it's no joke. The ending got met the Penguin and Catwoman got defeated, and now Batman from Michael Keane is the Batman. So overall, guys, Batman Return is such a great movie, but I prefer Michael Keane Batman from 1989 much better than Batman Return. Don't get me wrong, I like the movie, but honestly, I just prefer the first movie better than the sequel. And so, hey guys, at least it's way better than Batman. I love it. Worst Batman movie I have ever watched. And so, yeah, and I am giving back. Sorry about that, guys. Alright, guys, back what I was saying. So, yeah, guys, I'm. Damn it. Sorry about that, guys. Just stupid notification. I forgot to turn on my notification. So, hey guys, I am giving Batman Return a. So, hold on a minute. Alright guys, I am giving Batman Return a 8 out of 10. It's a great film. And sadly, this movie don't deserve a seal of Nick Awesomeness, because only seal of Nick Awesomeness that deserve is 9 out of 10 and 10 out of 10. That's my rule right there. So yeah, that was my movie review on Batman Return. Tell me what you thought of this movie on the comment section below, where I spoiler. Well, even I like the movie, but I prefer Batman from 1989, but much better Batman movie than this. And so, hey guys, so stay tuned tomorrow, oh boy, stay tuned for tomorrow, movie review, flash mini rant on Batman Forever. I don't understand why people like that movie, which honestly, I am not a huge fan of that movie to begin with. But don't get me wrong, it's not the worst Batman movie, but I think Batman Robin is way worse. That's my next review after Batman Forever. So, hey guys, so stay tuned for my movie review, flash mini rant on Batman Forever, which honestly, I cannot stand that movie. The movie was stupid and awful. And so, hey guys, if you like this video, hit the subscribe button, notification, children's family, and I don't feel like making Razzie reward rant, because this is the only video you're gonna get for today. And stay tuned for my two video tomorrow, which is Batman Forever mini rant, and stay tuned for my Razzie reward rant tomorrow, like looking at the stupid nomination. But the only nomination I really like is has to be Spaceship 2 getting nominated for at the Razzie reward. Good one animation group has freaking deserve it. How you make that movie like hip and the cool. Razzie don't like that. Freaking did big. So you guys, will see you next time. So long, I'll see you in my next video, everyone. Goodbye.